you know, from there, you know, we resumed a degree of normality. We put in place social distancing. We actually changed working patterns. We were going to change them anyway, but we threw the door open to various different working patterns.
Okay.
We now work three shifts, and the reason, part of the reason why we work three shifts is to allow for social distancing. So the employee population in the workplace is not as dense because we've spread those people over a greater number of hours. So, you know, and we've done all the changes with one-way systems and signage and, you know, all those sort of tactical things to make people feel safer in the workplace, masks, that kind of stuff.
I think just a couple of points that Lisa and Catherine made. You know, I agree with the sense that it is a level playing field in, you know, in respect that we're all facing that same challenge.
Uh-huh.
But people's jobs are different, and that comes back to
Catherine's point about segmentation, because,
uh-huh,
you know, one of the worries I have is,
you know, we have an office that has 133 people in it. It now has 25 people in it. They can all work from, great for them. The guys in the factory don't have that choice.
Yep.
They have to work. They cannot build a chiller or a product, you know, in a garage at home. It just doesn't happen. So, you know, there are different challenges with managing those constituent groups. You know, we have service engineers who, you know, were fairly high risk in terms of they would go into a hospital, for example, and do, you know, service on equipment and things. So, again, there was a different message to those people about, you know, what we needed to do. And it was interesting because they were getting, you know, lots of challenges from their families about not going because, you know, they're going into a hospital, which may put them at risk, which may put their family at risk. So, you know, we've had some interesting challenges around that. And then, you know, we have an office in London, you know, in King's Cross. Nobody's been in that office since the beginning of March. Empty. So, you know, there's lots of stuff in the news about people reviewing their office footprints in terms of, you know, how they're going to use things in future. And I think, you know, I think looking forward, you know, even the office in Leeds, which would normally, like I say, have 130 people in it, I don't think that's ever going to have more than 30 people in it, to be honest. I think managers need to get their head around the fact that maybe the office will just be a hub now that people go into and out of, you know, and that opens lots of things about, well, how are you going to manage, how are you going to measure people, how are you going to, you know, look at their output, you know, there's a whole thing there about new management skills that are required around how they're going to manage remote teams when traditionally they would have walked into the office and there 30 people would have been sat there.
Yep.